It's Ash from Super Videos back for another video for season 8 of The Walking Dead. In this video, I'm going to be doing the review for season 8 episode 3, which was called Monster, and also the promo breakdown for the next episode, episode 4, which is going to be called Some Guy. So if you're new here, this is basically a new way I'm doing things. First, I'm doing the review for the episode that just aired, and after that I'm jumping into the promo breakdown for the next episode and kind of breaking it down and giving my thoughts on what I believe we're gonna see in the next episode based on what we're seeing in the promo. So it has a bit of predictions in there as well for the next episode. So that being said, let's jump right into this with the review of season 8 episode 3, which was called Monster. So overall, I think this episode was a bit slower paced than episode 1 and episode 2. It still had some action, but I feel like it was a little bit slower paced and more story driven than the previous two episodes. So this episode was basically broken into four components, four parts of the story. The first one was dealing with Rick and Daryl attacking one of Negan's outposts from one side, and Aaron leading an attack at another part of the same outpost. And then another story involving Jesus and Morgan after they left the satellite station, and we basically touched base with them as they were bringing these prisoners from that satellite station to the hilltop. And then another part of this story was just at the hilltop, which was very brief, but it basically connected with Jesus and Morgan and the others bringing the prisoners there. And last but not least, we had the story with Carol and Ezekiel leading the Kingdom Army attacking another outpost. So starting with the first storyline, which is involving Rick, Daryl, and Aaron and some other Alexandrians. So for the first part, with Rick and Daryl, we basically started right from where we left off in the last episode with Morales. So first things I want to say about this, a big, big disappointment. You would think when they brought a character back after so long, they would have something special planned for him, but that wasn't the case. The only positive thing I saw in that was kind of building on that whole thing about Rick thinking about who he used to be and what he has become, and maybe questioning his humanity a little bit. That's the only positive I saw in that. So that's the only positive I saw about Morales' return. Other than that, there was nothing there. Although, I thought the way they killed him off was clever because, in my opinion, it was a nod or homage to Abraham's death in the comics and Denise's death in the show. So obviously those were the exact same deaths. They were just swapped with different characters, but we had Dwight killing them with the arrow through the head, and it came out of nowhere. And I feel like it had the same kind of effect, because it was in the middle of conversation, and then boom, Daryl comes. Rick obviously doesn't want this to happen. He tries to stop it, but Daryl ends up killing Morales. And, you know, that's basically the end of Morales. Now, like I said, I don't like the way his comeback was handled. I thought, first off, it was unrealistic, but then they brought him back for no reason. What was the point? Other than, you know, for him to come back a little bit and maybe get Rick to think about his past a little bit, what was the point? Other than that, I liked the way they killed him off. It was clever, although obviously I would have loved to have seen him for longer because he just came back, but I'm gonna do a standalone video just talking about the Morales death and, you know, his return and things like that. But for now, that's basically all I have to share. But then we basically have backup come, and Daryl and Rick have to fight their way out. I loved that part of it. I thought it was pretty cool to see them work together to try to get out of that situation. That was pretty epic. But then at the end, with that lone survivor there, I thought that was stupid. So Rick gives the guy his word, gets information out of him, and then Daryl just executes him right there. Now, I understand that Daryl just doesn't give a shit anymore and he's just killing all the saviors, but, you know, you would think that there would be some conversation between Rick and Daryl about not just killing people like that. Because, obviously, Rick didn't want Daryl to kill Morales and Daryl just executed Morales there. So, I feel like there would have been some conversation between the two. And maybe Daryl would have a little bit of his senses still in him to understand that Rick just gave the guy his word and they shouldn't just execute the guy. Now, obviously, that could come back to bite him in the ass if they did that, as we've seen in the previous episode, but You know, you still can't just do that. Even in this world, like Jesus said, we're gonna have to live with these people after this war. So I feel like they could have built up on that a little bit with Daryl and Rick, and they could have done a bit more. That's all I can say. Then going from there, we have the other part of the outpost with Aaron and the group attacking the other part of the outpost. I thought that was pretty cool. It was basically the continuation of when they attacked, which was the previous episode. That pretty emotional scene between Eric and Aaron. I loved that. I think it was great performance by the two of them. Obviously, Eric tells Aaron to go back and everything, so that was pretty epic too. But later on, when Aaron comes back, obviously Eric is no longer there and he has died and turned. Great performance by Ross Marquand as Aaron there, because, you know, it was perfect. The way he played that scene and basically transferred every emotion that Aaron was feeling at that time. I thought that was phenomenal, his performance and everything. But, you know, just to end this part of the conversation, we have Rick basically bringing Gracie out of that room and basically taking her with them. So now the whole thing about Gracie being Judith is somewhat questionable, because obviously Gracie is there, but as we saw, Aaron is going to take care of her, not Rick. So, you know, we are going to have to rethink that whole theory a little bit. But that being said, I thought it was pretty cool that Aaron came forward and offered to take care of the baby and everything. I thought that was pretty cool, especially with Eric having died and everything. I feel like this could be something to have Aaron hold on and fight and not give up. So that was pretty cool. Then in another part of the story, we have the part with Jesus and Morgan bringing the prisoners back and everything. We have that close call with the walkers. A herd comes in and they have to fight the herd off. And, you know, a few of the saviors run away, Jared being one of them. And we basically see crazy Morgan pop right up again. He runs after them and ends up executing one of them right then and there. Jesus stops him, and then we have this pretty epic fight between Jesus and Morgan. I thought that was pretty cool. A bit longer than I would have wanted it to be, but it was pretty cool. And also, at that moment, Morgan was not Morgan. Morgan was in clear mode, because afterwards, Morgan is confused. He doesn't understand what just happened. So he basically just zoned out and went into beast mode and started attacking Jesus. But one thing I want to say about this is that I'm going to do a companion video just talking about this whole fight between Jesus and Morgan and sharing my thoughts about why I think this was an important fight to have. But just for the purposes of this review, I thought it was a pretty cool, epic fight between the two. And like I said, Morgan was in beast mode and everything. Although I do agree with where Morgan stands, I don't think that that's the right route to take, to just fight people in your own team to prove a point. I think that is not the right way to go. But that being said, I'm going to explain that more in my companion video. That being said, now I'm going to jump into the Hilltop story, because that kind of connects to Jesus and Morgan and the others bringing the prisoners back. So back at the Hilltop, we have Gregory showing up. He's basically putting on a play and everything. Nobody really believes him. Maggie, Enid, Cal, nobody believes him, but they end up letting him in. Now, I hope that doesn't come back to bite them in the ass, because we can't trust Gregory. He's gonna do something. I can just feel it. But we're gonna have to see what happens there. But I love Maggie's comment. She says, he's not worth killing. So I thought that was pretty cool. And it's kind of true, you know. He's not worth anything. He's a worthless guy, because he would do anything to survive. He would lie. He would turn on the people that he calls family. He will do anything to survive. And, you know, that type of person is not worth fighting for. Is not worth killing even. So that was pretty cool and everything. But then what connects with this is Jesus and Morgan bringing the prisoners back. And, you know, it's going to be interesting to see what Maggie does. Right now, as it stands, it seems like she's going to agree to bring these prisoners in and lock them up and everything until they know what to do with them. But that being said, you know, that's not a smart thing, because there's women and children in there and their safety is being jeopardized with these people being there. So it's going to be interesting to see how that plays out. But right now, everything is on Jesus. Whatever happens, it's Jesus' fault. So we're going to have to wait and see what happens. And then last but not least, the storyline with Ezekiel and Carol. So at the beginning of the episode, we saw that epic scene with Ezekiel and the kingdom members, you know, seemingly surrendering, and then boom, Carol and the others pop right up and kill all of the saviors, which was pretty cool, pretty nice. Seeing Shiva there was pretty cool as well. I'm glad she survives another episode. Most likely next episode is not going to be looking good for Shiva, but for now she's alive, which is pretty good. But I love that whole strategy that they have, and you know, I thought that was pretty epic. I think that this is something we need to see more of, to see them planning things like that and surprising the saviors like that. So I thought that was pretty cool. So then the episode ends with the kingdom members and Ezekiel attacking the outpost they were going to attack. And initially, that attack is successful. They end up killing a bunch of saviors. They're successful. None of them die. Ezekiel is happy about it. And at that time, something clicked in me. I'm like, something is going to happen. And it did. So we have some of the saviors who are guard there shooting a bunch of kingdom members down and killing them. And, you know, they shoot towards Ezekiel and a bunch of kingdom members. I think Daniel was one of them. Ends up jumping on him and saving him, seemingly. We're gonna have to wait and see whether he survives. Most likely he will, because he is hurt in the promo of the next episode. But yeah, I just thought that was ridiculous. That took me right out of the scene, because they were all strategic, they were doing great, and then without actually clearing inside of that outpost, they're standing in the middle of the field and just talking. So if you know there are some saviors there and you haven't cleared inside, why would you be standing in the middle there without watching over your backs, watching up, watching to see if anything's wrong or if there's anything moving or anything like that? So obviously it came back to hurt them because they weren't paying attention and the saviors have the upper hand on them now. But I just thought Ezekiel is smart enough to kind of think about things like that and not stand there in the middle with all of his men and assume nothing is going to go wrong, even though inside of the outpost is not cleared. So that took me right out of the scene. That was ridiculous in my opinion. It was out of character for them to do that. So a bit of a con there. But speaking of cons, something I forgot is Morales. We have that conversation between Rick and Morales. Although I thought it was pretty cool to have that conversation, Morales' acting was just bad. It was terrible. I mean, it felt so forced, it felt so fake that it took me right out of the episode as well. So I'm sure the actor is a good actor, but this scene, he just didn't do it for me. It just felt so fake and so forced. But that being said, that's basically everything I wanted to share for this review. Overall, I thought it was a good episode, a bit slower paced, but it was more story driven and it had some cool moments here and there. But that's basically it. That's all I have to share. Now, jumping into the promo breakdown for the next episode, which is going to be called Some Guy, which is an interesting title. But let's get right into this. So starting with this shot, we have, obviously, this is the saviors who just shot a bunch of kingdom members and killed them. So this is the same outpost. And some of the bodies on the ground that we see here are saviors, but some others are kingdom members who have just been shot and killed.
Episode of AMC's The Walking Dead. We face dire challenge and chance.
So we have this other shot with Carol in what it looks like is the same outpost. Maybe they found a way to get inside. I don't think they would just go to a different outpost when they're being shot at one outpost. So I think this is most definitely the same outpost. And then in the background, we have a dialogue with King Ezekiel. And it seems like this is right after they have been attacked. And he's trying to rally his group and, you know, motivate them a little bit and tell them that they can still do this. Even though they've just lost some people, they can still win. So I think this is most likely right after some kingdom members died and it's Ezekiel's motivational speech. And then in another part of the promo, we have Rick in the same Jeep that we saw in the last episode and Daryl in his bike and they're going somewhere. Maybe they're going to another outpost, but it seems like at some point, they come by another savior or a savior is chasing them, but there's some sort of car chase going on. And, you know, we see that throughout the promo as well.
Rushing out of peace into war.
So here we have Rick in the back on the Jeep, and then we have Daryl riding in the front there. Now that I think of it, they're most likely going towards the same outpost that we heard the other savior who was executed tell them about. Obviously, he said there was a 50 caliber gun that was here, but it was moved to another outpost a few days ago or something like that. So they're most likely going towards that outpost and trying to get those weapons. And at some point, they're attacked or find a savior, chase them down. So this is most likely inside the other outpost where all of the weapons are. So this is the outpost that Daryl and Rick are going to. This is the other outpost where we have Carol and Ezekiel and the other kingdom members. So this is inside the same outpost, I believe. We have a close call with Rick with some walkers, but then we have Carol here. And there's some saviors shooting at her. This is definitely the same outpost. And they're basically trying to fight them off now. And then here we have the same chase scene that I was talking about. We have this guy driving what looks to be another Jeep. And then Rick on the side of him coming in with another Jeep and kind of chasing him down. Now, I don't know whether he's going to the same outpost or whether they just saw him along the way. But it definitely seems like they're going to try to kill this savior before they move to the other outpost.
We will fight.
And then this scene here, we have Carol seemingly surrendering and the savior is pointing the gun at her. It's going to be interesting to see what happens there because it could be part of their plan. We've seen them do something like this in the previous episode, so they could be doing the same thing. Maybe some other kingdom members are going to jump up and kill the savior, but for now, it seems like Carol is surrendering. Maybe she ran out of ammo or something like that, but it seems like she's surrendering. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens with her. This is part of the same scene. She's basically turning around. Now, it seems like there's more saviors in the back, so it's not just one savior, but Carol looks concerned. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens with her. And throughout the promo, like I said, we have the speech by King Ezekiel as he is rallying his group and motivating them to fight back and keep going and things like that. But very excited for the next episode. It seems to be another action-packed episode, maybe a bit more action-packed than the episode we just saw. But overall, I am very excited for this next episode. Now, one thing I'm kind of confused about is why we haven't seen Negan and Gabriel or anyone at the sanctuary yet, and why we haven't seen the scavengers. It's been 4 episodes, or 3 episodes for Negan and the others, but for the scavengers, it's been 4 episodes. We haven't seen them. So I wonder whether we're going to see them in this next episode. It doesn't seem like it. And if that's the case, I hope we see them in the 5th episode, because so far, it seems like there's a piece of the story missing, which is the scavengers, and also another piece that's missing, which is what happens with Negan at the sanctuary, you know, what happens there. But I'm pretty sure that they're going to visit Negan at the sanctuary in episode 5, but that being said, I'm not so sure we're going to see the scavengers in episode 5, but we're going to have to wait and see what happens. That's it for this video. See you next time for another super video.